Why so serious?
Is everyone okay?
I'm on serious.
You're on serious.
Because you guys are saying why you're all so serious. I'm on serious.
You're on serious.
It's so weird that he's sounding so gentle, cool. Like, oh God, let's catch cruise.
Why are you not so serious like me?
Oh my God, you are still listening to the Master Jam.
I'm fired.
Thank you very much.
All right, so Laycon, the man of the hour. I mean,
So, how many followers did you have outside before we got into the house?
3,000
in 2 months. Never done in Big Brother history. You were the first housemates to hit 1 million before coming out of the house. Your songs were all over on air, were jamming every time. Before coming out of the house, the love from fans. Do you know what I've been waiting for? His reaction. Because every time I watch the show, I'm like, I just didn't wait, make this guy come out. I want to see his reaction.
Yeah.
But a lot of people were actually saying, Shane go faint. From like 3,000 to like 1.7. How did you feel when you saw the love and massive support and following when you got out?
I'm not going to lie. I can't explain it with words.
Yeah.
Because, you know, when you say, this is what you want, but you know that the proper, like, or the way life works is you get it gradually, not or it's like you work and work and work and work and you don't see the progress, but probably there's the progress is stacking up somewhere or something, and then you do one thing that you're not even conscious about. You just say, okay, probably this will just push me up a bit, so I get noticed, then I build up from there. That was just the idea that I had in my head, probably go to Big Brother and get some form of, them even know that I am an artist. But then I came out
still overwhelmed.
Have
you
felt
yet? Like, have you?
You don't even.
Sometimes I kind of feel like it's, am I dreaming? Like, am I? Is this really happening? Honestly, so.
But it is. Oh, it is. You had a special bond with this four, especially with Miss here, which made me fall in love with you and you and you. You guys, every Saturday. Both of you. I kept saying, thank you, Nengi. Thank you for working with our guy. But how did the bonding start with you guys? With V, with Neo, with Nengi? What was the vibe between you and Nengi every Saturday? Because the way Nengi danced with you, she didn't dance with any other person like that. So what was the connection between both of you?
Nengi, I and her, we like started talking from the first day.
Yes,
he was actually the first. Okay, after Neo, he was the first person I spoke to.
Oh wow!
Yeah, so we started talking, but this man here made me put on that light that everybody was talking about. That's where he's on for V.
For V.
I think our first conversation was me correcting you on how to pronounce my name.
Yeah.
How did you pronounce his name?
Let me tell you something. This guy was so rude about it. I looked at his name tag and I said, oh, your name is Laycon. And he said, no, my name is Laycon. I was like, okay.
No, I noticed how she was the first person that changed when we got into the house. She went to change immediately. And I was like, then she now talked and she had this English accent. I'm like, oh, okay, nice. But then the switch up, I'm like, okay, this is interesting. But talking about how we got close, I don't know how, I don't know when, or I can't really put a timeline on it, but it just happened. It just happened.
Okay, so I would ask V this question.
Yeah,
like in the house, and you've mentioned it outside that you're more or less like a ride or die for Laycon. Why are you a ride or die? What is it about him that has put you in that position to say, nah, this guy, I got you?
The thing that I noticed about Laycon was he has like a godly spirit. He's very inviting. And I don't know, people always talk about what our friendship did for him, but people never notice what our friendship did for me. Laycon changed my mindset on a lot of things. There's a lot, there could have been a lot worse arguments in that house with me.
I told somebody.
Me! But yeah, okay, so our friendship has like, it's made me wiser. It could have been worse in that house. It could have been worse.
It could have been worse. All right, so Laycon.
Yes.
I want to take your mind back now.
Okay.
To day one.
Yeah.
When Ebuka says, ladies and gentlemen, welcome Laycon, and you're walking onto that stage. What was going through your mind at that very point?
I'm not going to lie. See, when I stepped on that stage, yeah, the light here was tense. Then the lights.
You were lit.
You were lit. Oh my goodness.
I was lit, yeah. So when I stepped on stage, I heard my song. That every. You used the discombobulated my brain. So everything that I say, just be calm, you do this thing, you do this, everything feel real, like, this is my song. So that was all that was in my mind. So when Ebuka was even asking, was like, don't play your song, they have played your song. So that was what was in my head. So he just asked the question, I answered him, I just went in. So on that stage, it was the fact that they played Accolades that was in my head.
That was in your head.
Yeah.
Lovely. All right. Ooh. So I have a question for Laycon. And it's about, you left out a very huge part of your life, of who you are in, until the very last week, which was the fact that you are a sickle cell warrior.
Okay.
Why did you do that? And the reason I'm asking that is because, I mean, I know so many, even me myself, when I found out, I was like, because I'm also a sickle cell warrior, I was like, I'm not sure I would not have dropped this information on day one at some point to maybe try and gather votes or something.
No.
I wasn't sure, but you kept it. And I mean, it was such a mind-blowing thing when it came out. Why did you take that decision not to divulge that information to everybody until
because
that time?
First things first is, I'm not the kind of guy that would want to get something out of pity. Yeah? I remember the only person I remember telling was V. And I just told her in like kind of a whisper. And she respects some certain information that I divulged to her. So, but that day, I think we were just talking about it. And I'm like, okay, yeah, something. It was even passing because we were talking about blood group or something. I was not like, my own blood type is actually the most expensive for like B negative. If you want to buy it, it's expensive. Then somebody now asked, what's your genotype? Then I could not.
You know,
I just said SC. And yeah, the next question was always whatever, the question I always get whenever I tell people my genotype. What is SC? SC actually exists. Yeah. So does CC. Yeah. So does AC.
Yeah.
Yes, they exist. And I think the issue is people don't know about it well enough for even people to now research about it. She also said it, that people do not know about it enough for doctors to even go and research on how to.
Yes.
But I hope that the right people are listening so that you can champion this cause, because it's a very important cause.
Yes, very, very.
And for somebody who doesn't know what SC is, in 1 minute, if you can just explain it to them for benefit of information.
Okay, SC, from what I know, is a very rare genotype.
Mm.
Same with CC. But the thing is, with SC people, some of them, as the sickle cell is dormant.
Mm.
For some, they experience it. And for those people who experience it, I know sickle cell, that's SS, from a tender age, you start getting sick.
Yeah.
But for SC, mostly, as you grow older, it gets worse.
Mm.
So when you grow old, it gets worse. Some people don't start having their crisis up until maybe their teenage years. And so they don't really know. And then a lot of hospitals probably will not even know that is SC, so they may just say, what is this? So we need to actually create awareness, and not just awareness, and we need to start finding solutions to how we can make sure that this thing, because I really feel like, okay, this is my job. I didn't know that I was SC up until 2012. I didn't know. So I felt like, if this thing has existed for a long time, why haven't people
when that information came to light, you see doctors now doing threads on Twitter about SC and all. I like the fact that you spoke up at that point in time, because when you spoke about it, awareness came out, and okay, it's not just AA, AS, SS. And I'd just like to say, before we leave, because we're almost done, I'd just like to say that from one warrior to another, you're an icon.
Thank you very much.
For bringing out, I mean, awareness about sickle cell. It's not just only about, oh, sickler, they are always weak and they don't know how to carry their
hand. Some of us are actually very strong.
Yes!
All of us are strong, actually.
We are fierce.
All of us are actually
thing I wanted to do throughout the day, just so I could see, my heart was in my mouth. I was on the phone with her, on the phone, like, oh my god, is it gonna win, is it not gonna win? I have never voted ever in the history of Big Brother. I have never championed anybody. I just watch it for the fun of it and for the work, you understand? But this is the first time that I was so invested in the contestants. This is the first time I went all out on Twitter, on Instagram, fighting people because of this guy.
Is this inaugural speech?
So yeah, I just want to say congratulations.
Thank you very much.
You are talented.
Thank you very
much. You are brilliant. You are intelligent. And I am so glad that you won. I know I'm not supposed to say this, but I have to, because I don't know when else I go see the guy. Maybe I'll talk stage, I'm gonna shout for as fun or back. So I just want to say shout out to you.
Thank you very much.
A lot of people proud, and I'm very happy. You know, another thing that I really love is your bond with this girl. You guys are, when I was crying, I'm like, I wish I had a friend, but like, I wish I had a guy friend like that, like guy that I could talk to, because I really like the fact that you put him back on focus. You steered him back in the right direction, because I felt if he kept on like that, it probably might have messed up his chances in some way or not. But I'm glad that you won. Congratulations to you.
Thank you.
Is next for Laycon?
That was...
You have discombobulated him.
Don't mind, I'm just a fan.
Obviously, it's music.
Mm-hmm.
Music. But then, like I always say, I will keep repeating it. I won. But for me, it's more than just winning now. Mm. It's more than just winning the show. It's about winning in life.
Mm.
And winning in life for me is when you've touched other people's lives.
Yeah.
When you've enriched other people's lives. So, like, multiple people have touched my own life.
Mm.
Now it's time for me to give back. So it's a cycle. So I love money. I want to make money. I want to live good. But then what do you do with the wealth?
Yeah.
You give back.
Yeah.
So that's basically what I'm going to be advocating for. That's basically the whole purpose of my existence in the world. The whole purpose of anybody's existence in the world is to touch other people's lives with whatever it is you have. So that's the whole thing that I'm going to be focusing on, using different avenues, obviously, using my music, using other means that I feel like I can use.
Mm.
So basically, that's it for me. It's pushing forward with my music. Yeah, I'm going to be releasing new songs.
Is it already in the studio?
Yeah, I've recorded DJ Neptune. You kinda shout out to DJ Neptune anyway.
He's on the Nobody remix.
Yeah. Also, I'm going to be shooting a video for hip hop. We're working on that.
Yep.
And yeah, so basically music, and other things. Also, I'm going to be going into different causes like cancer, sickle cell, and other things. But basically, you guys should just expect things, positive things.
Thank you.
God bless you.
Inside the LGA.
Can you hear it?
All right. Increase the volume.
It's up, baby. Inside the LGA coming up really soon.